Well, after having seen the suffering of the civilian population in northern Uganda, I'm appalled, frankly. It's a moral outrage to see thousands of children that have been abducted, that are maltreated, that are going through the most horrendous torture by the rebel movement, and also the same groups now being neglected to some extent by the whole international community. I cannot find any other part of the world having an emergency on the scale of Uganda with so little international attention.
And it's J-S-O-N-R-U-S-S-E-L-L. Have I ever traveled before? Yeah, I have. I've traveled to Africa once before, to Kenya. Nairobi, Kenya. Bobby?
Yeah?
It's blinking. I don't think there's any tape left. It's blinking red. Laren Poole, interview number one.
Bobby Bailey. That's B-O-B-B-Y.
My name is Jason Russell, and
have you ever traveled before, and where? No, I've never traveled before anywhere significant outside the States besides Mexico.
With Laren, I know that he hasn't even really gotten out of the country very much either.
It's so awkward here.
It's seriously awkward.
Media shapes the way we view our life. What you see in magazines, what you see on the TV screen, what you see in the movie theater is what you know about life. So in a sense, media is life.
So we are naive kids that haven't traveled a lot, and we are going to Sudan.
I think it will be fun. I do.
I'm not about fun as much as I am like deep, rich, nini.
Bobby is Bobby.
We all put up these walls and these boundaries.
So media is, it defines our life. So it is obvious choice to three kids who want to tell to find the truth. I mean, how?
Fare thee well.
Well, I'm not dating anyone. I don't have a girlfriend.
But I really feel like it's going to be a rude awakening for Bobby and for Laren.
It's gotta be an adventure.
In the spring of 2003, I went to Africa with my friend Laren. And my friend Bobby.
Bobby.
It's so bright.
Are you scared?
What the hell is going on?
Jesus.
Why so bright, you guys? Seriously. Jeez.
We didn't go with any organization, and we didn't have money, so we sent out these letters asking for support. We proceeded to buy our cameras and equipment off of eBay, got many shots, and then we set up our camera, thinking that if we didn't make it back from Sudan alive, this is how we'd be remembered. We never thought anyone would actually see the footage.
Do I think I'll die?
Do you think I will die? Do I think I'll die?
Hopefully that we won't die. But hopefully we will.
What am I most afraid of?
I'm afraid of dying.
I'm afraid of... people seeing this movie and maybe thinking differently of me. Because I'm still the same person that they've always known.
Colin Powell has been quoted as saying, "There is no greater tragedy on Earth today as the one that is unfolding in the Sudan." He says this because over 2 million have died, and 5 million have fled the country because of the 20-year-long war between the North and the South. The Southern Sudanese have experienced a Holocaust unlike any other since World War II. I had discovered this information a little over a year ago, and promptly afterwards decided to go to Sudan, wanting to document this hidden Holocaust and understand the repercussions of such a war as this. I also learned that because of the danger of the war, no one was permitted to fly into southern Sudan. But we decided to go, so we prepared for the worst.
You're going for a reason. I mean, you are going to see how other
how bad it is, and to share that with other people. And I think that in itself is something that is worthwhile and that you can bring back to those of us that don't know how bad it is. Then I get sad again.
I love you too.
I know. It's just not easy.
Dude, my heart's aching, but it's good.
We left the day the war in Iraq started. President Bush told us not to travel.
To disarm the Iraqi regime.
But we got on the plane anyway. None of us knew what we were doing. We'd never made a documentary before. We just opened our lens wide and tried to capture any stories along our way to Sudan.
It is on.
We arrived in Kenya and immediately started documenting a woman named Mama Sapora, who single-handedly started an orphanage called Haruma. She has over 100 children. She invited us to one of the Sunday services without informing us that it's customary in Africa for guests to introduce themselves. Most children at Haruma were there because the AIDS epidemic had killed their parents.
So we stay with these children.
They slept four to a bed and were often fed just once a day. But when they danced, they really danced. We left Kenya and headed to the country we had set out to explore and conquer, Sudan. We came to this country as naive travelers, but we were determined to face the danger head on and leave as warriors. After a treacherous journey, we finally arrived in Sudan, on top of the Nuba Mountains. And with it came a shocking 130 degree heat. And right from the start, we could tell this was not the adventure we had expected. There wasn't much to do.
I'm just trying to get the most depressing shot ever.
So, we blew up a termite hill.
I know what they got coming.
Ooh. Fought off a huge snake.
Do you feel it in pulling? There you go.
Shut up.
Light on it.
Light on it.
Ah. It's good. Well, okay. Here it comes. He's coming out.
Oh,
he's
my God.
He's coming out. Here.
Jump on it.
Oh,
my God.
Get the gas.
It's okay. Oh, you got it, girl.
And threw up a lot. Although there were many signs of war in Sudan,